Yeah, we move on to Marwa from Lalit last time. I think, yeah, we touched upon Lalit last time. The swara used, the Marwa thought is actually. And the pa, that is the Marwa thought. What Marwa does is it omits the pancha and so and uses the rest of this one. Now, one of the rules, basic fundamental rules, which goes into making of a rag is that a rag will not omit both the pancham and the madhyam at the same time. And this rule actually refers to the use of Shuddha Madhyam. Because Pancham and Shuddha Madhyam, they provide the fulcrum, you know, between the first half of the Saptak and the second half of the Saptak. If you take both out, you don't have a fulcrum, and it's impossible to build a rag. Now Marwa is omitting the Pancham on one side, and instead of the Shuddha Madhyam, what left with is a Tivra Madhyam. So that's the first deviation. The second deviation is every rag is based on a pair of notes. You know, every rag has to its core of the structure a pair which defines, you know, the chalan and the movement of the rag. And the swara in the pair normally are in a relation sa to pa or sa to ma. If you remember, you know, when we talked about malkams, we said that in malkams, any swar to any swar, if you draw up lines, they end up being sama or sapa. And within this sama and sapa is built the consonants, the pleasure. You know, they are consonant, they are in harmony with each other. And there is pleasure in connecting them together. So if two swars sound like sa and pa of each other, or sa and ma, then it gives pleasure. And this happens to be one of the fundamental principles of building up of a rag. In case of Marwa, what is paired is the komal re and the dha. Which do not have this relation. You know, they neither have a sapa or a sama relation. In fact, the relation is quite dissonant. Dissonant is opposing of consonant. So if consonant is good sounding to the ear, dissonant is jarring to the ear. And Marwa is based on a pair of dha and re, which do not have this consonant relationship, and still you are trying to build a rag around them. To complicate matters, what happens is the sa is almost omitted. Sa is given a complete back seat, and you know it is there. Sa of course is there, but you normally don't rest on sa as much as you would in any other rag. So now imagine you have a structure which you know, it's like balancing on a bamboo where the fulcrum is not at the center. It's skewed and you are still trying to balance on it. And that is why, you know, it becomes very, very difficult for an artist. You know, for a listener, it doesn't, you know, matter all this. All this is in the background. But what matters is the effect is created if you get it right. And what is the meaning of getting it right? You know, in case for every rag, when you say that an artist, a singer or an instrumentalist is spending years of his life with a rag, what is happening is the chalan and the basic aroha, avroha are basic rules. I mean, everybody knows them. The crux of getting the essence out of the rag is in getting the pairs right and getting the intonation right, getting the right relationship between them, hitting them exactly on a microtonal level at the right spots. And from this angle, exploring the relation between dha and re and making marva stand upon its own becomes a lifetime pursuit for any singer. And marva is probably the rag which is respected so much. It is treated with such respect by musicians that for every musician getting marva right is a feat. So this is the background. We will of course get into how you still try to lift up the rag. So now what is more interesting on this background is using exactly the same notes, there are two other rags. Now we generally know that two rags can have the same set of swara, but then if the chalan is different, if they are used in a different way, then they can make up different rags. Now this exact same set of swara, omitting the pancham, also creates two more rags. One is Puriya and the other one is Soni. And both of them are so very different. In fact, all three are completely different. For a musician, it's impossible to mix them. And that is the beauty, that's the beauty of evolution. Imagine how, at what point you start getting such intricate structures with such minute differences, and they make a complete sea of difference in the final structure of the rag. So what we are actually going to do now is, before we get into the marva phrases, we will briefly look at Puriya and Soni and then get down to marva. So what Puriya does is it uses the same set of notes, but instead of the dha and the re, it gives the sa is quite prominent, and the dha and the re get a complete backseat attention. It is absolutely, they are almost non-existent. The daivat remains there. So let's see what happens, The re is, and the nishad becomes, the ni becomes very prominent. Dissonance problem. The ni and the ga are in complete consonance with each other. The ni and the ga share the sarva-sama relation. And then you go on exploiting it, it works. And so, and because of the ni, prominence of the ni here, this is the tivrama. This is the knee again. Korea. So what it has done is it has completely sidetracked the common Rishabh and it has solved that problem of dissonance. Sony very smartly omits the Re altogether in the ROI. Jumps right into the upper part of the octave, and so Sony is a completely different depiction of the same set of swara, and so you know this is a beautiful example of the same set giving you completely different rags just by the change of changing the core pair and changing the strum, the chalan, the third element which gives them very different identities is the you know I spoke about the microtonal positioning of the notes, and this is where all these rendering of these rags and keeping them separate becomes still more difficult for an artist. So let us now look at Marva, and so what's happening is set of notes we are talking about, and we are now going to try and pair the this is going to be the axis around which Malva has to be built now. So now itself up, and that is you know in seeking you know consonance with that dha. If it becomes shuddha re, it will become consonant with the dha. Now the komal re can also be very close to the sa instead of close to the re, and that is what Puriya does. Doesn't want to show the ray at all, but here we have to now focus on the ray, and the ray then tries to meet up with the dha, so to say, and so it pushes itself up. Becomes the defining part of Marva. So this re, if a concert begins with this re, re 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 ni da, da ni re re ni da sa. It's always ni re. Because the nishad also, the ni also is not elongated. So you know this tells you about the interplay between this one and so on. Oh. Another thing which happens in case of Malwa is all these swara are hit directly. There are no means or no soft connections. You know, they are all khada swaras. Hit them right at that spot. And then come and rest on the dha. The dha becomes very, very, very strong and prominent. But then we are not going to use it. Marwa doesn't use it. Soni uses it. But here, you will not rest at Ga. This was Marwa for you. Exhausting it is.